All right, so welcome for our Mercy Health Stepping Out program, yoga. Thank you so much for joining me tonight. My name is Michelle, and this is just a Hatha yoga flow. We always like to say that it's a personal journey, so do the version of the poses that feel most comfortable to you, be it a lower level or a more challenging level. So go ahead and join me in our comfortable seat. Sitting up nice and tall with our shoulders relaxed. And start being more aware of your breath. Try to release any thoughts and worries with every single exhale, letting them go one at a time, whatever visualization works for you. Go through a series of box breaths. I'll count to four several times. On the first one, we'll inhale for four, then we'll hold our breath for four, exhale for four, hold your breath for four, before we go ahead and inhale again. And we'll just cycle through a few times. Press both palms together at our heart center. Let our chin sink to our chest. And set your intention for your practice this evening. Think about what you hope to get out of your time on the mat. Lifting our heads back up, we're going to release both hands to our sides. Lean our head so that our left ear is coming towards our left shoulder. We'll bring our left hand up and over so that our fingertips touch the top of our ear, and gently we're going to pull, thinking of lengthening the neck instead of trying to pull the head down. We're just going to try to lengthen our neck. Release the left hand down.
right hand will follow up and over for a side stretch. Shoulders are stacked. Both of our sits bones should be anchored to the earth. Bring that right hand down to the mat. Walk very carefully, slowly, pulling her forward all the way around to the other side. Once you get to your right side, that left arm can open up into a side stretch. Try to find where you can get those shoulders stacked again. Make sure that that hip, that left hip, is not pulling up off of the earth. Up, left hand will come to the right knee, right hand will wrap around, we'll look over that right shoulder in a spinal twist. Switch foot's in front. Right ear to our right shoulder. Right hand reaches up and over. Lengthen the neck. Right hand down, left hand reaches up and over to a side stretch. Left hand comes to the earth as well so that you can walk your hands in a big arch. Around to the other side, feel that in your hips, take your time where you need it. When you get to the other side, plant your left hand and let that right hand come up to our side stretch. Sitting up nice and tall, right hand to the left knee, left hand wraps around, straightening up, we'll look over that left shoulder into a spinal twist. Straighten first one leg and the other into our staff pose. Sitting up nice and tall. And flex those feet so that the heels pull up. And relax slowly, folding forward in front fold. Pulling or bouncing, you're just relaxing. With each breath, try to just let go a little bit more.
We'll roll back up to a seated position and swing our legs around and come to our tabletop. As we come to our all fours, make sure the knee is in line with the hip, hip distance apart. Wrist is in alignment with the shoulder. Spread those fingers nice and wide. Keep our shoulders active. And always pull in our core. Start with our cat-cow breathing, so feel free if you're familiar with that to go ahead and get into your breaths. But we inhale, drop the belly, opening up the chest as we go into cow. And then as you exhale into cat pose, you're tucking in your tailbone, tucking your chin in, arching your back. And you just flow between these two breaths, in and out. Taking your time so that you can warm up your spine, add some extra moves in there, whatever your body needs to get warmed up. Finish one more set and we'll meet in a neutral spine. Lifting the right, keeping the right leg bent, lifting that right knee out to the side. This is our fire hydrant pose. We're going to begin our circles, our hip circles. We're going to do five of these. Go in the opposite direction. Be mindful of your shoulders. Don't let them sink in. And we'll go to the opposite side. Left leg out. Ahead and begin whichever direction you want. We're going to go to both directions, so. Whenever you finish your five, go ahead in the opposite direction. Touch knees as wide as our mat. Let our hips sink back to our heels. Stretch those hands forward before melting into your mat. Forehead touching. And you can rock it back and forth a little bit here. If it feels better tonight to support your head, feel free to do that. Rolling back up to our tabletop. We'll straighten our legs back up so they're in alignment with our hips. And lower all the way down to your mat. Keep those elbows pressed in. And we'll press into our cobras here. Get our back warmed up. So as we inhale, we'll press up, keeping our shoulders down, our elbows in. Exhale back down. Inhale up. You can try to go a little higher. Make sure your spine's not collapsing. And exhale down. And last one, inhale up. Exhale down. Press back through our tabletop, tucking those toes so we can lift our hips up to downward facing dog. Walking our heels out one at a time. Keep your eyes looking in between your feet. As you start coming to stillness, we'll get our alignment here. Our ears should be in between our arms. Our pelvis should be tilted forward a little bit so you get a straight line from your heel of your hand up to your tailbone. And you can press those heels towards your mat, and that'll start straightening your legs out. Go ahead and walk forward. And you can gently bend those knees here as we come into a forward fold. Grab the opposite elbows so that you can go into a full traction here with your upper body, letting it completely free. Release the hands. We're going to roll up slowly to a standing pose. Down pose, and then we're going to squeeze those shoulder blades together when we get to the bottom here. So exhale down, and then as we inhale, we'll go back up. Exhale down to our and inhale down. Go ahead and release the hands all the way down to a forward fold. And we'll step back, first one foot to a tabletop here. So go ahead and bend all the way down. And then the other, coming back to tabletop. Extend that right leg out, lifting it up so that the leg is parallel to the earth. Draw that knee in towards your chest. Swing the foot all the way through. Now right here, do a check. Make sure that this knee is not in front of the ankle. Go ahead and scooch it forward if you need to. And once you have your balance, we're going to rise up into our crescent lunge. We can inhale those hands up. And maybe even look up to the sky. Breaths to our cactus arms. So exhale down. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. And exhale.
hands to our mat. We're going to let them swing through, shifting our weight to our back leg. We're coming into a half split here. So this supporting leg should stay perpendicular to your mat. The front leg is straightening out, and we pull those toes up off of the mat. As we relax, we let the nose come towards the knee. And you can walk those hands forward if you want a deeper stretch, or keep them supporting you so you don't wobble over to the side. Shift our weight forward, plant the left hand, that right hand raises in a spinal twist. Right hand comes down, right foot back to meet the left into our tabletop. Same thing, other side, lift that left leg out, draw the knee in towards our chest. Swing the foot all the way through. Go ahead and take a moment to get that foot where it needs to be. Once you have your balance and a strong foundation, go ahead and lift up. And then our arms. Breath here, or breath work, we'll add our cactus arms. So the exhales, down, squeeze the shoulder blades, inhale up, exhale lower, inhale up, exhale lower. Release the hands down, shift our weight to the back leg, straighten the front, pull the toes up off the mat. Release the nose towards the knee. Go ahead and walk those hands forward if you can. And shift our way back to the front. Plant the right hand, left hand raises. Spinal twist. Left hand comes down. Bring our left foot back to meet the right. And we'll do a vinyasa flow right here. So we're going to lower down to our mat. Inhale up to a cobra. Exhale back down to your mat. And press back up to tabletop. That would be our level one. So whenever we do our vinyasa flow, or as we go into our downward facing dog, if that gets to be too much, just go ahead and return down to your tabletop, and you can do any of these things from there. So let's go ahead and tuck our toes, and we'll return to that downward facing dog. Shift our weight to the left foot, the right foot raises in a three-legged dog. Try to keep the hips square to your mat. Don't let them open up here. Draw that knee in towards your chest before letting it swing all the way through. We're going to come to a low lunge. And we work on trying to keep light on our fingers here. So let's see if we can lift up. Stay nice and low. Raise those hands. Exhale down. Inhale. Exhale. Exhale. Release the hands down. Left hand stays, right hand up. Right hand comes down. We'll bring that right foot back to meet the left. Shifting our weight to our right foot, left foot raises in a three-legged dog. Draw that knee into our chest. Swing the foot all the way through for a low lunge.
light on our fingers so we can stand up. Exhale down. Vinyasa flow. If you want to do the one we did last time, feel free. Otherwise, that left foot comes back to meet the right in a plank. Or you can do a half plank. Lower down to your mat. Inhale up to a cobra. Exhale down to your mat. And if you did your half plank, lift back up to the half. Or if you did a whole plank. And then we're all going to press up to downward facing dog. Bend both knees deeply. Look to the top of your mat. Let's make our way there. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, we're going to go about halfway up, keeping a straight back, long neck. And then exhale, forward fold. Inhale, root to rise. And we'll bring our hands to our heart center. Shift our weight to our left foot, right foot raises, three-legged dog. Knee to chest. As we swing that foot through, we're going to rotate the back right foot so we can come up to a warrior two. In warrior two, we make sure that that front knee doesn't roll in and it once again isn't too far forward. Make sure that our upper body isn't tilting forward. We have to keep it nice and square here. And both arms are level with each other, looking over the right hand. We're going to pivot that right foot forward. Hands will come up. Turn around so that my back's not too there. Wait. And we're going to do a goddess squat. So the knees go out over the toes, and the arms are going to open up into that cactus pose. And we're going to do, as we raise up, inhale, exhale, plie, and raise up. And down. Okay, sorry about that. So now lower our arms back so they're both parallel. We're going to turn out the left foot, lower down to warrior two. Cartwheel the hands down. Right hand plants, left hand rotates in a spinal twist. And back down. Bring that left foot back, meet the right, downward facing dog. Shifting our weight to our right foot, left foot raises, three-legged dog. Knee to chest. Swing your foot all the way through. And we're going to raise back up to warrior two. Rotate our back, our front foot. Hands will up and together. And we'll do our goddess squats once again. So as we exhale, we lower down. Inhale up. Rotate the right foot forward, lower to your warrior two. Heart with the hands down. Left hand stays rooted, right hand goes up. Right hand down. We'll bring that right foot back to meet the left into a plank. And your vinyasa flow, whatever that looks like for you. Lower to your mat. Inhale up to a cobra. Exhale back down to the mat. Up through plank. Downward facing dog. Bend both knees deeply. Look to the top of your mat. Make your way there. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway up to a flat back. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, root to rise. And stand with our hands at our heart center. Where my balance is terrible today, again. Maybe that's an always thing. But we are going to do a balance posture today. So we're going to shift our weight to our left foot, and we're going to start with that kickstand. We're going to go into a basic tree pose. If you want to use the wall, you're more than welcome to do that. All right. So remember, your core gets engaged the moment your foot leaves the earth. So it's awesome if you get your foot all the way up here. That is not what's mandatory. Literally the moment your foot leaves the earth, everything is engaged, everything is doing what it needs to do. Keep the knee turned open. And make sure that foot's not pressing into a joint, so not directly into the knee. If you want your tree to grow, obviously it's not for me. Go ahead and shut your eyes, see if you can do that. Lower down. Did anybody shut them? No? All right, we'll go to the other side now. Shift our weight to our right foot. Start with your kickstand. Just start engaging from there. Checkpoints, one of our power poses. Inhale our hands up. Exhale, forward fold. And you can go ahead and squat and lower down to your mat. Hands up and exhale, let them come forward and sink towards the earth, just surrendering,
Each exhale, just try to relax a little bit more. Walk our hands back, sitting up nice and tall. And we can switch which foot's in front. And again, inhale up. Exhale, forward fold. And relax. Walking our hands back. I want us to do one staff pose because we did one to begin with. Now that our muscles are warm and we've used them a little bit, just to feel the difference. It might not look any different to anybody else, but just to feel the difference in your own body. So we're just going to surrender down to our staff pose, folding forward. Remember thinking about lengthening and not just crushing our nose down to our knee, just relaxing. Inhale up. We're going to lower down to our mat. You want to do your yoga roll down, hands out. Tuck that chin under. Don't let those feet leave that mat. Keep them there. We'll draw the left leg in. God bless you. Draw the left leg in. We'll raise that right foot up to the ceiling with that right leg straight. Go ahead and just do some ankle circles to begin with. Make sure you go in both directions. Now, since we are going into the cool down, try to just think about every breath we're taking, just relaxing a little bit. And yes, we are still going to do a little bit, but not like we were doing. And bend that leg, draw that knee in. You're going to hold it in with our hands. And that left foot's going to straighten out along the mat. If you can, go ahead and let it hover. Don't let it actually touch the earth. And you know I'm going to do it to you. So go ahead. Lift that upper body, trying to get the shoulder blades off. Imagine that piece of fruit underneath your chin. And we're going to switch. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Right foot plants, left foot raises. And again, do some ankle circles. Both directions. Draw that knee into your chest. Good stretch in there first. And lift the shoulder blades off the earth. Looking down, but keeping that chin up here. And we're going to straighten that right leg out. If you can, let it hover. And we'll do 10, starting with this side. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I must do that one, sorry.
And both knees.
Again, let's plant that left foot, right foot up to the ceiling for just a moment. We'll cross that right ankle over that left thigh, opening up the right hip. Lift the left foot off the earth, bringing both thighs towards, well, bringing the left thigh towards our chest as much as you can. And then we're going to lift up one more time here on this side. Reach back with both hands so they can interlace behind that left thigh. And as we lower down, we're going to pull that left leg with us. This is a reclining pigeon pose. And again, there's variations here. You can flex your feet, see if that feels any different, if it feels good. You can keep this top leg so that it's parallel to the earth, or you can tuck it in and have your hands actually on top of your shin, pulling in. See if you like that any different. Or going back to the traditional hold, you can straighten that left leg out. All kinds of options. Release the left foot down, and then the right, and we'll do the same thing on this side. Left foot up, cross it over the right thigh. Lift that right thigh towards our chest as much as you can, and then go ahead and lift up and reach behind to pull it back down with you. Neither, you usually have one side, a little different than the other, so even if it didn't work on one side, you could still give it a try on the other, just to see what it feels like. Lower that right leg and then the left, so both knees are bent. Arms are going to go out straight to our sides, and with the legs together, we're going to let both knees fall over to the left side. And if it feels comfortable tonight, look over our right shoulder. All over to the right side, and then you can look over the left shoulder. Head up, knees to the center here. Walk the feet in as close to your sits bones as you can. Both arms come down alongside our body. Starting with a pelvic tilt, we're going to lift that pelvis up off of the mat towards the sky. One vertebrae pulls up off of the mat at a time. Supported bridge. And one vertebrae at a time. Release back down to our mat. Release first one leg and then the other as we come into the Shavasana portion of our practice. Go ahead, if you need any extra props to be comfortable, we're going to be laying here for a few moments. You'll begin with a body scan, going through all of our major muscles, trying to come to a complete relaxation. And then you'll just lay in that stillness for 2 or 3 minutes. Quiet. All right, so we're going to begin with our toes. Breathe. breathe relaxation into your body, feeling it flow through the feet. Allow it to climb up the legs. Welcome the relaxation in our hips, feeling the legs maybe roll open a little bit. And with each breath that we take, we're getting heavier onto our mat, just melting into the earth. Relax the hands. Feel those fingers curling up naturally. Finally, relax the muscles of our face. Imagine all of the tension, all of the stress being pushed out of our bodies, out of the crown of your head.
Challenge for you to this week is for you to sit in your nakedness. No, I don't necessarily mean your physical nakedness, but I mean your mental. We very quickly and easily put on a happy face to make sure that people think that everything's okay, a brave face. Things are going badly so that other people don't stress. So many different sides of us that we build walls up around ourselves that other people see to make them comfortable, to make them better, to make them happy. That we don't allow ourselves to have our own feelings, those moments of just being what you feel what you are. So when you get to sit and be quiet, just sit and let yourself be raw, be open, be who you need to be, who you are. No walls, no barriers, just naked. When you're ready, you can go ahead and roll over to one side, cradle your head with your arm. And return your thoughts to the intention that you set at the beginning of your practice. Let that be your inspiration, maybe your anchor, your guide. Remember how you feel right here, right now, every time you think of that. And let it help you on this journey. When you're ready, go ahead and join me in a seated position.